Hi guys, welcome to day 4 of our Advent calendar of yoga. So as I promised with today's practice, we're going to try and move the body a little bit more today. And I thought it'd be nice to focus on a series of stretches to target the hips. So they tend to be a part of the body that physically carry a lot of tension. If we have jobs where we have to sit a lot, it can really shorten our hip flexors. And then in terms of energetics, we tend to store a lot of our emotions, a lot of stresses actually energetically within the hips as well. So it'll just be, again, quite a short practice, something that hopefully you can fit in easily into your day today at whatever time is suitable for you. So in terms of things that you'll need, try and have space enough for your yoga mat. We want to be able to have space to lie down for some of the poses and stretch out, and also space enough to do a couple of downward dogs as well. You might need a block or something similar to help you with supporting some of the poses. So if you don't have a yoga block, a kind of thicker hardback brick can be useful for that as well. And maybe a yoga strap as well, or something similar, like a tie or a scarf, something that you can just use to hold onto your foot in some of the poses as well. Okay, so we're going to start lying on our backs. So if you want to make your way down onto your mat, we're going to start off with the breath. So bringing yourself into a position on your back where you can feel comfortable. So if having your legs out long doesn't feel very nice for your spine, you can bring soles of the feet together, knees out wide, or feet to the width of the mat, knees knocked together. So however you're starting your practice, try and allow the body to really relax and let go. So maybe giving your shoulders a bit of a shuffle from underneath themselves, turning the palms to face up, and begin to focus the mind on your breath. So starting to take really conscious, long and deep breaths. So breathing in, feeling the breath in the belly, feeling the breath in the rib cage and all the way up into the chest. As you exhale, releasing the breath from the chest, from the lungs, from the belly. Softening the muscles of the face to see if you can relax across your forehead, relax through your jaw. And whatever's going on for you today, depending on when you're doing this practice, you might be doing this and you've still got some of your day left, you might be doing this at the end of your day, but whatever has already taken place, or whatever you have yet to come, try and leave all of that to one side and just allow the mind to abide in the here and the now. You're with your breath and you're with your body. And in this way, you get a real mental break for the next 10 to 15 minutes. If you want to take a Sankalpa, a positive intention for your practice, you can begin to draw that into the mind as well. So maybe something or someone that you'd like to dedicate your practice towards. And then slowly start to draw your legs in towards you. You want to take the heels towards the tailbone as close as you can get them. And then bring the arms a little bit away from the sides of the body. So you're just going to start with windscreen wipering the knees and getting into the hips. So you can take the knees over to the left and then turn your head over to the right. And just allow gravity to start to draw those hips down. And then try and take some really nice deep breaths into that right rib cage. inhale, knees to center. Take the knees to the right and then turn your head to the left. Again, try and focus your breath in the left ribcage. Draw the hips down towards that right hand side. Try and relax your shoulders as well here. Knees back into centre. I'm going to hug the knees into the chest. Take a little gentle rock from side to side. I'm going to keep hold of the right leg. And you've got an option to either keep this left leg bent or begin to stretch it down to the mat. Depends on how you're feeling in your hips and your legs. I'm going to take half happy baby pose. So from here, start to bring this leg up. You want your sole of the foot flexing up towards the ceiling. And this is where you might want your straps. You might want to take a strap or your tie or a scarf, wrap it around the foot, and then hold the leg out to the side. If you can reach, you're welcome to take hold of the toe as you draw the knee towards the armpit, and then left hand to left hip to anchor the hips down. Try and relax the shoulders, and we're trying to breathe into that right inner thigh. You might also feel a stretch to the front of that left hip flexor as well. And then draw that leg back in towards you. And we're going to stretch that leg up towards the ceiling. So keep a bend in this knee and try not to stretch too much too soon. We're going to circle the ankle a few times one way, a few times the other. So you can draw that leg in a little bit more. And then bend the knee. And we're going to swap sides. So left leg is going to come in. Option to keep the right leg bent or we stretch it out to the mat. And then using your strap or taking hold of ankle or the toes of that left foot and then drawing that leg out to the side, left knee down towards left armpit. Right hand is placed onto that right hip to anchor the hip down. Nice deep breaths, breathing in to that left inner thigh. Keeping the face soft. And draw that leg through centre, hands to the back of the left thigh. So you stretch that left leg up. Again, a little softness in the knee. And circle the ankle. You can bring the leg in a little bit closer without overdoing it. And bend the leg. Good. So from here we're going to take happy baby. So you bring both knees in and then start to draw the knees out to the side. You'll probably already start to feel that in the inner thighs and then we flex the feet up to the ceiling. So you can either keep hands to the inner thighs as you draw the knees down, keep reaching those heels up, or you can take hands to the lower legs, the ankles, or the toes. So be careful, if you're reaching the toes, you don't want your tailbone to lift up off the mat. So you need to be able to keep your tailbone down and the crown of your head. So if you can't do that and keep hold of the toes, then you need to back it off. You need to come back up the legs. Okay, so from here, a little bit of gentle rocking from side to side. It's a really nice posture to decompress the spine. Try and keep chin slightly tucked into chest. And again, just soften your face and notice how much you clench the jaw, frown through the forehead. We're going to bring the feet together. We're going to interlace the hands around the feet and then start to lift your chest, your shoulders and your head off the mat. And we're going to press the feet into the hands and hopefully you can feel a stretch into the trap muscles, the tops of the shoulders. And release yourself back down, draw your knees together. And you can either rock and roll yourself up to seated or roll to the side and bring yourself up that way. So whatever works for you. Okay. I'm going to twiddle ourselves into cross leg position. And start to walk your feet away from you. So you've got a little bit of a space between the back of the legs and the pelvis. And we're going to flex the toes. If you wriggle around and try and find your sit bones. And then from here, take a big breath in. Reach the arms up overhead. And as you exhale, begin to fold forward. So fingertips can come to the floor or palms. Start to tip the head down, slide the shoulders back. And we're going to hold there and breathe. Every inhale, try and create some space. Every exhale, we're looking to find some length. You might start bringing the fingers forward. You might start lengthening a little bit more with every exhale. But don't allow your shoulders to lead. So don't do this, okay? So shoulders need to stay soft. Palms together, inhale, lift yourself all the way back up, exhale, release the hands to the side, and then just tip back, swapping legs. So same thing, we want space between pelvis and the back of the legs, we're flexing the toes, so this side will probably be tighter because it's our least favoured side, so just be aware of that. Take a big breath in, reach the arms up overhead, and then exhale, folding forward, listening to your body. So if this is your tighter side, you might not be able to come as far forward, and we really need to respect that. So try not to force your body to meet or match the other side. So for me, it's my left side, so I can't come far as forward, so you just stay where you can, and you breathe. Shoulders are soft. Again, you might find after a few breaths that those fingertips can lengthen yourself forward. Good. Palms come back together. Inhale, lengthen all the way back up. And exhale, hands to the side. And then just cross the legs back to their original side. You can bring the feet a little bit closer in towards you. You're going to take the left hand down to the mat beside you. Reach up with the right arm. Take a big breath in. And then as you exhale, stretch it over to the side. So you either stay looking down to that left hand, or if it feels okay and it's okay in your neck, you can rotate the chest. Look up underneath that right arm. Nice deep breaths. And press that bottom hand, draw yourself through center, take a big breath in, and then exhale hand to the other side and reach up and over. And again, you can rotate the chest and look up to the ceiling if it feels okay. If it feels all crunchy or uncomfortable in the neck, just stay looking down. And then inhaling, drawing yourself all the way back up. From here, we're going to transition into Balasana, child's pose. So come into the back of the mat, and we want to get this into the inner thighs and hips for today. So walk the knees really wide, try and keep your big toes together. And then when you're ready, you can lengthen the arms forward and bring the head down. So if the floor feels too far away for you, get your block and rest your forehead up onto your block. And then spread the fingers wide, try and press your hands into the mat like you're pushing the floor away from you, and start to draw the tailbone down towards the heels. Concentrating your breath now in the back of the body, so breathing into the space between the shoulder blades. And as you exhale, releasing the rib cage towards the floor. One more breath. Exhale, bring your hands about halfway in, draw the knees together. And then we're going to set up to come into downward dog. So bringing the hands out in front, spread the fingers wide, tap the toes. Lift knees, lift hips. And then begin to lengthen your heels down towards the floor. So looking back between the feet, And then you might want to pedal the legs out a lot here if your hamstrings feel really tight. So those of you that come to my classes know I go on about this all the time, but please protect your wrists. So try not to just be here on your wrist with relaxed fingers, all your body weight going into your wrist joints. So spread fingers wide, middle fingers facing forward, and press into your fingertips, into your knuckles of the fingers, knuckles of the palms, almost creating a lift in the heel of the hands. And then looking out for hypermobility, so if you have that, try not to lock your elbow joints and press out the backs of your knees. So soften your joints, and then you want the strength to be coming from your core, so squeeze belly, lift hips high, and then draw the head back, looking between the feet. Breathe, it's more than likely that you stopped breathing while you've been concentrating on all of that. So nice deep breaths. And then I'm going to transition our right foot between the hands. So if you're starting out with yoga, this is quite difficult. So if you're happy doing it, step right foot in between hands. If not, come practice with me. So bring the knees down to do it and then step the right foot forward. Okay, just gives you a little bit more support. I'm going to bring hands to the inside of the right foot and then walk the right foot to the width of the mat and turn the right toes out. So we're coming into lizard pose, so quite a deep hip opener. Okay, so you've got choices. You can either stay here onto fingertips. You can grab a block if you feel that you need a little bit more of support. Again, careful of your wrists, so don't just crush all your body weight into your wrist joints. But find a way to place the hands that makes the wrists a little bit happier. Now you can stay with the back knee down. Any difficulty with having knee in contact with floor, grab a pillow underneath that back knee, bit of clothing, or you can actually do this pose off the knee, but it makes it a little bit more work for the legs. Okay, so your choice. I'm gonna stay off my knee because I have problems with my knees. And then you can either stay lifted, or if you wanna work a bit more deeply, you can start to work the forearms down. Sometimes it's one arm, sometimes you can do both. You can interlace the hands and bow the crown of the head down. So that's a choice if you want it. Okay, if you're looking at that and just being like, how the hell is that going to happen? Then you're just staying up here and you're breathing into that hip. Remembering, of course, you've got that knee down if you need it, using any padding if you need it. And we're going to breathe. Two more breaths. Good, and then bring your right foot back through center. So you've got your hands framing the front foot. And then start to peel the toes back, straighten the leg as much as you can or want to, taking a hamstring stretch. So bow your forehead down towards the shin. Try and slide the shoulders back. Okay, we're going to replace the foot. Now, option to either come straight back into downward dog, or you can do what you did before, so knee down, step it back to tabletop first, get your hands set up, and then downward dog. Lift the hips, stretch the legs, looking back between the feet. Pedal out those legs. Think about the connection of your hands. And then setting up for the left side, so look to the top of the mat. You can either step the foot through from downward dog or the knees come down. The left leg steps through. Bring your hands to the inside of left foot. As you walk your left foot wide, turn the toes out and then hands come back to center. And then any of those options, so you can come off the back knee, you can pad that right knee out, you can grab your block to place your hands on, and you're welcome to stay there and breathe. Or you can work more deeply by bringing the forearms down. Again, there might be a difference between the two sides, so be careful, don't force the body. Wherever you are, nice deep breaths. And just try not to transfer that hip tension into your jaw and into your forehead. So if you need it, you might even want to exhale through the mouth. Good. Slowly start to bring yourself back up. Wriggle that foot back through centre. Peel the left toes back, finding hamstring stretch on the second side. Coming down as far as feels okay for you. And again, slide those shoulders back so the neck is long. Good, we're going to bring that foot down. Hands firm the front foot. And then either step back to tabletop or lift the back knee and slide that foot back into downward dog. And we're going to pedal the legs out. And then we're going to come back to Balasana, child's pose. So knees down, tailbone down towards the heels. Stretch the arms forward, forehead down. And give the hips a little bit of a gentle rock from side to side. Begin to walk your hands in towards you till you come up to a kneeling position. And then slide your hips out from underneath you, take your legs out long. And just give the legs a little bit of a shake out. So you're going to take one more pose, and then we finish our hip, or small, short hip sequence for today. So we're going to take reclining pigeon pose. So coming back down into your back. So we're going to start off crossing right foot over the left thigh. So depends on how your hips are. So for some people, this is enough. And you can just actually stay there and apply a gentle bit of pressure into that right thigh. Okay, this is also where you might want a strap or whatever you're using for your strap. So we're going to try and take this left leg in towards us. So one hand, your right hand goes between the legs and then wraps around to the back of that thigh. So for some people with really tight hips, you actually can't reach that leg. So you wrap your strap around and then you use your strap to pull that leg in. Okay. So you want to be able to have your shoulders and your head relaxed. You don't want to be like this. Really, I do see that a lot as well, people just being here. So it's not really very relaxing for the body. So head and shoulders down, use a strap if you need to so that you can start to draw the legs in towards you. So alternatively, if you find that kind of easy or you're not actually feeling much of a stretch, you can do a couple of things. So you can flex the right toes back a bit more and you can actually take your hands over to the top of the shin and draw the legs in. So that normally makes that quite a lot deeper. And then we're going to breathe. Again, be careful with your face. So notice if you're transferring hip tension to the jaw, or to the forehead, or to the shoulders. Try and soften everything else and really send your breath into that right glute, that right hip. Good. We're going to release. So we're going to bring the left foot down, but keep the right leg crossed over. Draw arms out to the side, and we'll take a little gentle twist. So you're going to start to journey that right foot down towards the floor. It may or may not reach, don't worry if it doesn't. And then turn your head to the other side. Pivoting on that left foot, rolling yourself back through centre. And we're going to swap the legs. So right foot disconnects, the left leg on top of the right thigh. And then option to stay there. Or grabbing a strap around the back of the right thigh, drawing the legs in. Or hands to the back of the right thigh, drawing the legs in. Okay, so as I said before, if you need a little bit more, flex the left toes back towards you. And an option to wrap around to the top of the right shin. Once you've found your shape, deep breath. If there's any pain in the knee in this pose, we need to come out. And that's kind of a general rule in yoga anyway. Any pain in the knee, something is wrong and we need to change the pose. It's not something that we breathe through or that we work through. One more breath. Bringing that right foot back to the mat. Arms out to the side. And the left foot goes to travel over to the right hand side as you turn your head to the left. Try and really relax the shoulders. And then draw yourself back to your centre and hook the leg. Hug those knees back in. Give yourself a little rock from side to side. And then you've got choices from here. So you can either lie down in Shavasana or you can come up into a seated position and do some breathing that way. So it's up to you. Okay, so I'm going to bring myself up to seated, but if you want to come into Shavasana, then you start to lengthen the body out long to your mat, or take those choices that we had at the beginning. So the soles of the feet can come in together, four of the feet wide, knees knocked together. Okay, palms facing up. So find the pose that works best for you, or you can come up into a seated position if you feel that you need to be a little bit more alert. Closing the eyes. And just paying attention to your breath. Watching the breath as it moves in and out of the body. Noticing if your mind begins to wander to other things, and just bringing your awareness, your attention back to your breath. As we did yesterday, if you've got the time and you want to, feel free to stay in Shavasana for longer. Or you're very welcome to play the video from yesterday, the relaxation practice, and take that as your Shavasana as well. Or if that's all you've got time for today, you know, gently, if you're not already in a seated position, draw your body up to seated. Take your time, moving carefully and slowly. Bring yourself into Sukhasana, your easy seat. I'm going to draw palms and hands together into the Anjali Mudra. Coming forehead to fingertips, shoulders sliding down the back. And we're trying to lift up through the crown of the head, at the same time earthing through the tailbone. Just being here with your breath for a few more moments. Coming back to that intention you made at the start. And just dedicating your practice to whatever that intention was. And seeing if you can take this feeling of calm and spaciousness within the body and the mind into the rest of the day or evening ahead of you. And we'll take a big breath in. As we exhale, bowing forward, sealing your practice for today. Coming back up when you're ready. Okay, so thank you very, very much. I hope you enjoyed that, and I will see you tomorrow. Thank you. Namaste.